क्षेत्रीय सत्ता के अंदर ही हमको ये नजर आता है कि कैसे पूरा कॉन्सेप्ट डेवलप किया जा रहा है. आप ऑनर का कॉन्सेप्ट डाल रहे हैं, द बर्डन ऑफ दैट ऑनर इज ऑन द वुमेन, व्हिच बोथ ऑफ देम हैव पॉइंटेड आउट. And that burden in terms of a whole lot of other categories also, and it's not just marriage across, but perhaps violating the principle of community and religion is how they are trying to defend it. That's the whole notion of this is the community, whether it's a gotra or the larger
gavand,
so a cluster of villages that we are looking at here as well. It's something that is a created phenomena which is sought to be. So there's no choice that the family has really. When you're saying, do we believe in? We don't. But we have to live within that larger setup. This is not a small enemy we are fighting. It's a horrific lot of, you know, the whole family is part of this whole setup that we're looking at. It's very subtle. It's very insidious. And it's very organized. So I think even the relief or even the fight that has to be there has to be very organized and with a commitment. With the courage of the commitment that we are not going to let it follow. So it's not just the marriage itself. It is refusing to agree to an arranged marriage, being in a relationship that is disapproved by the family. So the family decides the relationship also. Having sex outside the marriage, that's also a cause for this. Actually becoming a victim of rape, you're also ostracized then. That also becomes getting dishonor. How is that victim responsible for the rape? We are doing this blame game of actually blaming the victim constantly. And here it takes it further from not just blaming the victim, but actually ostracizing and actually treating that as an honor concern. Dressing is another issue that, you know, in inappropriate ways. So the family will decide this is how you dress, as they spoke about, having mobile phones, jeans, you know, jeans became an issue as well. A week back, there was this horrible pictures in the paper, which were taken by, in Madras, in Chennai, taken of women on mopeds and sitting behind in leggings and stuff like that. And they're not aware of the fact. I don't know where where our freedom, rights to freedom are going, because they're actually looking at it. They're not even aware of it. And it's the backs of people sitting on the pillion and otherwise and trying to say, is this the way women need to dress? And it's actually there in national dailies. It's really horrific when we think about the extent to which the family can. What makes it really horrific is it's your own family doing it. So this recognition, I mean, we need to understand why is the family doing it somewhere along the line. And it's not just, as I was saying, it's across the world that we're looking at. We're looking at many years back also. But the characteristic, distinctive nature of honor killing essentially is that it's collective. The collective nature of the crime. So you can't identify one person. So even when you identify, they're let loose, you know, in all the cases that you mentioned. So many members of an extended family plan the act together. So it is something that the psychology of a family doing that is worth looking at also. The control over women's behavior, supposedly, bad behavior, you know, the fact that you're talking to somebody, talking on the mobile, all that, probably, you know, the whole notion of questioning sexuality here, talking about male interaction, marriage, a whole lot of concerns. It's also the reputation of the family which becomes very central, what makes it so distinctive. Reputation of the family within the community and the stigma. What they say is the stigma attached. The stigma is not attached when that girl is killed or, you know, she's taken to task. But the stigma is that she's, you know, broken these norms. Norms decided by the larger patriarchal society that we are speaking about. And in different ways, through different communities that we're looking at, you know, we have, it happens, you know, she's talking about the jats here. You have all kinds of, you know, rules which apply. Machismo in Brazil, you know, that you're looking at. In Peru, you have the Luca laws which pervade. Mexico, Aztec laws. They actually have within it a whole lot of parameters which are looking at honor killings from the perspective of how we are going to place this woman in subjugation. Essentially, subjugation is the bottom line that we're looking at. So I don't know whether we should call it honor or dishonor in some senses killing or horror killings, because it's horrific the way it works. What is the most distressing aspect which has been emphasized here, which is distinctive about honor killings, is also reputation of the family and perpetuators don't face any negative stigma. As Nonika said, in fact, they are celebrated, they are applauded as veer and as having done something which has restored the honor of the family. That's so worrisome, that aspect, that the fact that this, the community sees them as heroes. and that heroic act of, you know, saving the family. So there's the public display of violence, which again has been mentioned by both, which is applauded, which is celebrated. So the whole, it's like a psychological thing that, you know, the associations, when we look at it, is from this larger perspective of how do we change the norms, because the norms are pre-decided somewhere along the lines. But I think if we need to stand up to it on a whole, and it's becoming an urbanized phenomena also now, you know, it's coming pushed to that end. And somewhere, you know, please, we'll have questions on this as well, but largely there is a political economy to this, which we need to see through. A vote bank, a cost-benefit analysis that is being done at that larger level, that the benefits of applauding these wheels are more than that, because you'll have these wheels actually having the backing of the rest of the community, who'll all probably en masse vote, or on a whole lot of issues that we're looking at. So it's not a simple fight, because it's very subtle, it's very insidious. And it is, has the family also caught in a trap? Willy-nilly, you're also caught in a trap, because where do you get out of it? In what way do you get out of it?